Well, it's that time of the morning again where we get together, we talk just for a few minutes about the Word of God, and I hope that this morning this passage in 1 Peter is a help to you, because there's supposed to be such a difference between who we used to be and who we are now that people take notice of it. In fact, in 1 Peter chapter 4, verses 1 through 4 or 5, somewhere in that range, we'll see that there is supposed to be a response from people, almost like a taking back from people when they see that we won't do the things that maybe we used to do with them, or we used to participate from the side with them and we no longer will. Notice it with me in verse number 1. It says, "For as much then as Christ hath suffered for us in the flesh, arm yourselves likewise with the same mind. For he that hath suffered in the flesh hath ceased from sin, that he no longer should live the rest of his time in the flesh to the lusts of men, but to the will of God." Huge difference between the two things. I mean, you might be thinking, "Oh, before I was saved, I didn't live in the lusts of the flesh." Well, anything we do to satisfy us in place of God is the lust of the flesh. And so it doesn't have to be steeped in drugs or living an insanely immoral life. You could be living, quote unquote, as a good person, finding your own way through life apart from God. And that's the lust of the flesh, because you're using whatever in this world will make you happy. He goes on and kind of isolates some things for us, though, because he is talking about sin. He says, "For the time past of your life may suffice to us, suffice us to have wrought the will of the Gentiles when we walked in lasciviousness, lust, excess of wine, revelings, banquetings, abominable idolatry, wherein they think it strange," listen to this, "that ye run not with them to the same excess of riot, speaking evil of you, who shall give account of him that is ready to judge the quick and the dead." And see, the people that we used to hang out with, or the people that live in ways that do not honor the Lord, they're going to think it's strange that you have separated yourself from their ways. It doesn't mean that you have abandoned them and turned your back on them, but you no longer can promote their ways, and you can no longer participate with them in their ways, because you have made a declaration that you are a child of the Lord God. And so they should see the difference. Living a biblical life is different than living a life based in this world. And it doesn't mean, like I said, it doesn't mean that you were a person who lived on Skid Row in homelessness and now live in a mansion. It means that you have turned from sin. Sin has varying degrees, but it's all the same result, a separation from God. And so God says that if you actually have his mind, if you actually have his spirit, you will walk according to his word instead of according to this world. And so there's a striking difference, even if we're talking about the difference between what is generally been always considered good behavior in the world versus godliness according to God's word. And so I want to encourage you this morning, live in such a way that those around you notice that you no longer run with them. You don't run from them, but you don't run with them in the things that they do. Too many believers today are running with those that are in the world and trying to win them to Christ while doing the same things, or at least giving them permission to continue to do the same things. God's word says, pull out, come out from among them and be ye separate. That's the sanctification process we talked about on Sunday. And so I want to encourage you, live in such a way that people can see the difference. Not that you're telling them how different you are. Live differently. Don't tell them how bad they are. Live godly. There's a big difference between those two things. And so I want to encourage you with that this morning. I hope that helps you as you interact with coworkers, as you talk to your neighbors, as you maybe even have opportunity over the holidays to speak to loved ones and family members. Use the time to be different. Not to pretend to be different, but to actually be different. It's going to take a little bit of effort, and I hope that helps you, helps it by encouraging you that it's worth it. Have yourselves a great day.